You might be aware of the new Docker SOP, where automated builds in Docker is no more a free feature. The only way to achieve this from a Docker perspective is to upgrade to a pro plan. But if you are a small-time developer like me and perform commits rarely, this is not a very feasible solution for us. Here is where GitHub Actions comes to the rescue. Using GitHub Actions, all we need to do is write a small YAML file that will build a Docker image and push it to Docker Hub whenever you make any commits to GitHub. Step 1 is to create a GitHub repo for your Docker image. If you are already using the old Docker automated build system, you must be having a GitHub repo too, so you can use the same. Step 2 is to compose a Dockerfile. Again, if you already had an automated build in the past, you would be having this Dockerfile too. I have written a very simple Dockerfile that will print my name on the console when it is run. Step 3 is where we write our GitHub workflows YAML file. GitHub actually provides us with a template for this, so we need not worry much about this. Just head to Actions, then click on Setup this workflow for the Docker image workflow. Step 4. Edit this template YAML file that you get. Change the name of the Docker image and its tag to your actual one. You can see that this template only has a step to build the image. We also need to push the image. To do that, add an extra step below. Name it as push the Docker image. And in the run part, write a script to log into Docker Hub and then push your image to it. You can see here that we are storing the password as a GitHub secret. I will show you how we can set that in the next step. Just commit this one for now. This build will actually fail because we do not have the token set. That is fine. We will retrigger the build after setting the token. Step 5. You need to get a Docker token for yourself. If you already know what this is and have a Docker token, you can skip to the next step. Otherwise, for getting the Docker token, log in to Docker Hub at hub.docker.com. Then click on your profile and go to account settings. Then go to the security section and click on new access token. Give a description to the token. I am going to name mine as token with all permissions. Then click on generate. Make sure to copy the token and store it in some place safe like your password managers or Google Drive. This is the last time you will see the token, so make absolutely sure to copy it. Also, don't share your token with anyone else. It is as powerful as your password. I will deactivate this token as soon as I complete this video. That's it in Docker Hub. Step 6. Get back to your GitHub repository. Head to your repository settings, then go to the secrets section. Click on new repository secret, then name it as Docker token because that is what we used in our YAML file too. Paste the token that we copied from Docker Hub. Click on add secret. Step 7. Trigger the workflow. I am going to make a small change to the code so that the build gets re-triggered. There is an alternative way to manually trigger builds. I will cover that in the bonus tip section towards the end of this video. That's it. Now you should see the workflow run successfully. Go to your Docker Hub repo and you will see your new Docker image there. Let me just run that image and show you what it does. We have successfully completed building and pushing a Docker image using GitHub Actions. Time for the bonus tip. You saw how I did some hacks to trigger the build. This is because by default, GitHub doesn't allow us to trigger a build from the UI. The fix is simple. Open your workflow YAML file, then add a line called workflow dispatch under the on section. Commit this and you will see a button called run workflow in the actions tab for your specific workflow. You can manually re-trigger your build from here anytime you want. That's it for this video. See you in the next one. Bye.